Britain's Conversation. This is a podcast from LBC.
Nicholas is in Plymouth. It's near the sea. Nicholas, what would you like to say?
Hi, James.
Hello, mate.
I'm calling as someone who voted Remain. But I really have to say, I think what you're basically saying is that somehow or other the referendum was illegitimate because
Completely legitimate. That's why I've concluded that Theresa May has done quite a good job.
Can you just give me a chance?
Well, if you say something that's not true, I will correct you. But other than that, fill your boots.
Okay. During the campaign, basically both sides talked rubbish. One side if we left, it would be milk and honey. The other side said that if we left, it would be a complete economic disaster.
No, I need to correct you there. Some people made predictions that haven't come true. Some people issued demonstrable falsehoods about what we would legally be allowed to do. So when David Davis said, on the morning after the referendum result, we'll be in Berlin, not Brussels, doing a trade agreement, he was either spectacularly ignorant or actually lying. When the governor of the Bank of England said we may have a recession and then took measures immediately after the referendum, this is what the people who were pouring snake oil into your ears never add. So those predictions didn't come true. Mark Carney moved heaven and earth to stop... No, because you've already said two things that aren't true. So Mark Carney moved heaven and earth to stop his own predictions from coming true. So there's no false equivalence between the two sides, Nicholas. On one side, you've got predictions that didn't come true. On the other side, you've got liars. Carry on.
As someone who voted Remain...
Well, so you keep saying, but that's irrelevant to this conversation.
I basically believe that people ignored a lot of what was said on both sides, rightly or wrongly, thinking that it was exaggerated. But what they did understand was the basic point that, on the one hand, the Remain campaign was saying we are going to take an economic hit...
Which we have.
...if we leave. And on the other hand, the Leavers were saying we will be better able to control immigration if we leave.
Which wasn't true.
Well, immigration was down 90,000 last year, net immigration.
And we haven't left. And we haven't imposed the EU rules that we're allowed to impose.
So once we've left, we will see. Obviously, it will be up to the government to implement policy.
No, but again, mate, I have to correct you, because you said an untruth. We could have controlled our borders better if the government had decided that they wanted to. We didn't have to leave the European Union.
That wasn't the case. I said that people had voted on the understanding, and I think...
The misunderstanding.
Better able to control immigration...
On the misunderstanding, Nicholas.
The European Union.
The misunderstanding.
No, I don't think it's misunderstanding, because obviously with free movement, you cannot...
Why did you vote Remain, Nicholas?
Pardon?
Why did you vote Remain?
So I weighed up the...
Well, just give me the big one, the big swinging decision.
Basically, I felt that the economy was more important than immigration.
So you believe Project Fear?
Yes, in effect, I believe Project Fear. Not to the extent the Project Fear was suggesting.
But to the extent that it determined your vote.
We would have lower economic growth, which I think we are having, than if we'd remained in the European Union. It's not a disaster. We're still growing.
We've moved from the top of the growth table to the bottom.
You've
forgotten that you're defending the Remain vote. You kind of forgot that that's what you said at the beginning of the call. And on the immigration stuff, with the greatest of love and respect, just Google it. Google what European Union law is with regard to movement of labour. 3 months. If you haven't proved that you've either got the capital or a job, then under European Union legislation, you could be ordered to leave. Did you know that when you rang in, Nicholas?
Yes, I did.
And yet you still carried on. That's typical Remain voter, I suppose. It's coming up to 11 o'clock, and if he's a Remain voter, I'm a fish.